the old three-card chicken never fails.
But what if we do get caught?
You know what that means? Chop!
Ooh, yeah. I'm rather attached to my head.
And I'm rather attached to my hands and my feet.
Another bits.
Oh, don't you worry, Mr. Rada. Now the plague is over, things is getting back to normal. And this great city of London is full of opportunity. Especially if you're a banker like us.
Yeah.
They say these streets are paved with gold. For us.
In this city you can make a small fortune. Well, first of all, you have a large fortune, then he gives it to us to look after. Oh, what to look at? Oh.
Get out of here, you vagabonds, you wasters, you bankers! You see them plagued and kill all the rats. Must note that down. Chased off to feckless financial fellows. Yes. Ah, good evening. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Samuel Pepys, famous diarist and secretary to Charles II's Navy. Yes, and welcome to my fair city of London, a wonderful place, famous for fine women, fine wine, fine song. Yes, and now that those awful Puritans have gone, we're having a great time under our merry monarch, Charles II. Yes, Charles. No chinless wonder he, not like his father, Charles I. In fact, come to think of it, Charles I wasn't really a chinless wonder, was he? He was rather a headless wonder. I rather like that. Anyway, Charles II, the Merry Monarch, is a man after my own heart. Yes, he likes the good things of life. Going to the theatre, Dreary Lane, chasing the ladies. Yes, he and the court are probably down at Dreary Lane Theatre as we speak. And given that we've had such a long, hot summer, they're probably all dancing in the street.
Calling out around the world, are you ready for a brand new beat? Summer's here and the time is right for dancing in the street. They're dancing in Pimlico. Down in Westminster, in London City, all we need is music, sweet music. There'll be music everywhere. There'll be swinging and swaying, the lioness playing, dancing in the streets.
Maybe go quite queer.
Oh, take it easy, Orange Mole. You know the doctor told you to slow down, or else you'll go bust.
I think I've gone bust already. Oh, you girls, I can't understand why you're not all getting going this evening.
Oh, you do a great job, Orange Mole.
Well, she done you proud, ain't she, Nell Gwyn?
Couldn't do better than to match with the blooming king himself.
Oh, that's only because you took a fancy to me oranges.
Oh, you mean your melons?
No, none of that jealousy. Our Nell's done very well, but there's plenty of fish in the sea for the rest of you.
Some are definitely more fishy than others. That Duke, he looks like an off-big cod.
No, he's more like fish fingers, if you ask me. He gets his hands all over you.
That's no way to talk about the Duke of Cheapside. He'd be a catch for any one of you girls.
Oh, but he is a bit soulless, though. Mm. Although he does have a nice place in the sea. He's a bit of a shark, though, actually.
I see, I was right, Pollock myself.
But he'd give you a whale of a time.
This script is sponsored by Birdseye.
Yeah, that Duke, he's with the king all the time, trying to ingratiate himself.
Ooh, ingratiate! Aren't we getting posh?
Oh, you know what I mean. He's always trying to get close to the king. He's always scheming, trying to make more money.
Oh, he gives me the creeps. Oh, I wish we could find work elsewhere, far away from men like him.
Oh, Rose, my dear sister, life has been hard for us, but look at me now. Consort to the king himself. Oh, I know I'll never be anything more than his plain thing, but I do get to wear nice dresses and eat nice food, and it's always party time for me when the king's here.
Oh, you're right. We are destined to these playthings, but why can't I choose a man I want? Someone who'll love me as much as I love him.
Oh, who do you mean?
Now, you two, stop daydreaming. It's me, Orange Nell, you have to thank for everything that you've got. If you weren't one of my girls, you'd be on the streets, not actresses in the great Dreary Lane Theatre.
Oh, yeah. Orange Mole, you've taught us everything we know.
I know.
How to walk and talk like a lady.
Yes.
How to wear fine clothes. How to put on makeup on. Oh. How to go shopping for shoes. And how to look really attractive to men, just like you are yourself.
I know. I must be one of the best-looking girls around here.
Oh, yummy. You're a bit of all right.
I said you're a bit of all right.
I'm not here to talk. I'm here to guard the king.
Now the king's safe enough, don't you worry? Ain't you got time for a bit of fun? I'm one of the good girls around here, I am.
Yeah, but good girls are just bad girls that never got caught, just like me.
Oh, come on. Break it up. Come on. Anything in trousers is in mortal danger around here.
Watch it, the king's coming.
Make way for the king.
Look here, Cheapside. I'm tired of listening to all your plans.
Yes, it's very simple, Your Majesty. Take a look at this. Yes. I want to knock down this surgery here, open up this space there, cobble all this bit, and erect the new super shoppy here.
I don't want you to knock down everything in Pudding Club Lane to make way for one of your newfangled super shoppies.
But it's very simple, you actually. You see, super shoppies are the future. You can buy everything in one place. Cigs, figs, wigs and pigs.
I worry about you, Cheapy. You need to lighten up a bit. Look at me, out partying till the early hours of the morning, then up with a lark to go hunting. Boy, oh boy, do I have a great time. Do you know what gives me the energy, eh? Nudge. It's my little Nell. Isn't she a beauty?
Yes, sir.
Come here, Nell, and give us a cuddle. This is what you need, Cheapy, eh? What? I want to light the old fire.
Yes, of course, Your Majesty. You're absolutely right. And which one of these lovely actresses would you suggest?
Oh, well, I don't know. Nell, you've got a sister, haven't you? Isn't she called Rose or something?
Yeah.
Where is she? Well, there she is. What do you reckon, Cheapy?
Perfect, Your Majesty. Just perfect.
Well, get on with it, man.
Yes,
I'm off. Got to go and see the old queen person. Yeah. And my wife. Bye-bye, Nelly. See you later. Keep the fire burning for me.
Yes. Not a bad idea, that. With Rose as my consort, a fine foursome we would make. That would get me really close to him.
the king and I and two tarts. I've got plans and she's now part of them. She's bound to fall for me because I'm a big fish in a big pond. A great catch for a silly little actress. After all, I am the greatest. I am the one and only. It's nobody I'd rather be. Ha ha ha, yes. Nothing's gonna stop me from building the biggest chain of super shoppies in the world. I can see it now. Every high street in every town will have a cheat code.
Any luck?
I got the Duke's handkerchief. What about you?
Just a bottle of the King's coat.
What a mean lot. Don't even have a penny in their pockets.
Here, Rose, what do you make of that Duke of?
Oh, he's not my type.
Is he a flounder?
Oh, I think you mean a philanderer, but, well, maybe you're right. Yeah, he is a flounder. Right, you lot, here's a farthing. Go and buy yourself some cakes at the baker's shop.
Yeah! Oh, Rose, you're going to have to stop spoiling them like that. You're too soft.
Well, I know, but we were like that once, and now we're so lucky. Especially you, Nell. Think back to the poverty we came from. If our friends could see us now.
If they could see me now, that little gang of mine. I'm eating fancy grub and drinking fancy wine. I like those East End fans to see for a fact. The kind of top drawer, first rate chums I attract. All I can say is, wowie, look at where I am. The lonely landed pow right in a pot of jam. What a sense of holy cow. They'd never believe it if our friends could see us now.
If they could see us now, our little dusty group, straighting round this million-dollar chicken coop. They to the thrift shop cat, say, brother, get her. Draped on a bedspread made of three kinds of fur. All I can say is, wow, wait till the riff and rap. See just exactly how he signed his autograph. What a build a holy cap. They'd never believe it if our friends could see us now.
If they could see me now, a lonely Mr. C, who's waiting on me like he was the matron D. I'd hear my friends all saying crazy what this. Tonight she's living like the other of this. Who'd think the highest brow, which they all say is he, would pick the lowest brow, which there's no doubt is me. What a build up, holy cow. They'd never believe it if our friends could see us now.
What a step up, holy cow. They'd never believe it if our friends could see us.
Something though. I heard the King talking to the Duke of Cheapside, and I think I heard him say that maybe you should become the Duke's consort.
What? Oh no, I don't want to be anywhere near him.
Oh look, he might not be all that bad. I mean, being a consort to the nobility means a few parties here and there, and some nice dresses. Much better than trying to sell oranges or trying to be an actress.
But where's the love? How can I give myself to a bottom feeder like that? That's a technical fishing term. No, I want someone who's going to love me and take care of me. Not some highfalutin duke who'll drop me as soon as it takes his fancy. No, my art belongs to someone whom I can love.
Delivery! Oh, fresh from the oven, bread rolls, oh, bacon, yeah,
I'm starving. And the way.
All right, take it easy. Anybody will think you wouldn't eat for days.
You cheeky thing. An attractive lady like me can't go round looking like a half-starved cat, no can she?
Well, if we must continue these fishy jokes, I think you look more like a full-stuffed whale than a half-stuffed whale.
Orange Mole, leave him be. Look, Toad bought a lovely cake for you as well.
Now I've done all that running around and lost a bit of weight, I'd better have a slice.
Oh, Rose,
you're a treasure. I mean, for saving me like that. I was hoping you'd be here tonight, but that cake was a present for you.
Oh, Tom, you mustn't. You'll get in real trouble if Orange Mole finds out. You know we're supposed to get matched up with rich gentlemen, even nobles.
Yeah, but I know, that's not what you want.
Oi, what are you after? Banks, come and show this baker's boy the door.
Right, come on, doughboy. It's time you went back to where your knee...
Right,
show them.
We can't have the likes of him sniffing around here.
Thank you very much, Banks. It's me he should be after. I'm the only free girl in the theatre.
She's free, all right. With her looks, nobody would pay. Orange Mole, you are a nightmare. I mean, a dream come true. What man could resist you?
Of course. Don't you think I'm just a little bit sexy? Sits alone, waiting for suggestions. He's so nervous, avoiding all her questions. His lips are dry, her heart is gently pounding. Don't you just know exactly what they're thinking?
If you want my body and you think I'm sexy, come and sugar, let me know. If you really need me, just reach out and touch me. Come on, sugar, tell me so.
He's so shy, looking for an answer. Come on, honey, let's spend the night together. Can he catch a cab to his high-rise apartment? At last he can tell her exactly what his heart meant. If you want my body
and you think I'm sexy, come on, sugar, let me know. If you really need me, just reach out and touch me. Come on, honey, tell me so. If you want my body and you think I'm sexy, come on, sugar, let me know. If you really need me, just reach out and touch me. Come on, sugar, let me know.
Oh, hello there! Hello, sweetie. Yes, there's lots of little lovelies here. Oh, this one. Stuff. I'm getting too old for all this.
It's time you had a lie down.
You're absolutely right.
Thanks very much.
Now, what's it like with the king?
Oh, well, no one can't tell you that.
Does he kiss you?
Does he buy you flowers?
Well, yes. Well, what I mean is, he's kind. It's fine. He buys me things, like jewellery and nice dresses, and he takes me out. But he never takes me home. Aww. I'll always be, well, here.
Aww. So ain't it Tom your sister called herself a sugar daddy?
Yeah, Rose, what about that Duke then? Is he dangling on the end of your line?
Aren't you going to reel him in?
Can see with that dead fish.
Oh, imagine a dead fish kiss.
Oh, leave her be. Let her dream of a lover boy.
Yeah, we saw you. Tom the baker's son. Stole a kiss and away did run.
He'd steal a lot more than that if you gave him all for chalks.
Well, he's a real good looker, but he ain't got no money.
Yeah, Rose, you're going to have to forget about that, Tom, I'm afraid. He's no good for you. He'll just lead you to a life of poverty. All right then, everyone, let's get ready for the next show.
Yay!
Cheer up, Rose. We hate to see you sad.
Yeah, you ain't got no farthing, have you?
We're still starving.
Oh, go on. Here you are.
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Tell me you've got a sovereign? Hey, give it here. I'm going to show you how to make one sovereign into two sovereigns.
You can't do that.
Oh, yes, I can. Well, being a banker, just watch. First of all, I'm going to lend this sovereign to you. and you are going to write an IOU on this piece of paper.
What's that?
The technical name for IOU is a future authorised repayment transaction. F-A-O-T, for sure. Next, you are going to lend the sovereign back to me. Thank you. And I am going to write an IOU or a fart on another piece of paper. Now then, there you go. Now we have one sovereign and we have two farts, each of which is worth a sovereign. Agreed? Agreed. Now all we need is for a taxi to come along. Oh, look, here comes Bounce. Bounce, the old mucker. Have I got a bargain for you?
Oh, brilliant. Oh, I like the bargain.
Tell me more. Here we have two farts, each of which is worth a sovereign. But I am going to sell them both to you for just one sovereign. It's a really special deal. It's called a you can bog off two deal. Special this week only.
Well, that's brilliant because I'm collecting farts for me pension pot.
Well, oh, done. Now then, you put these safely away, and when you want two sovereigns, you bring them back to us, and we'll release those farts back to you. There you are, Mr. Arthur. You see how easy that was? We've got two sovereigns, and Bounce has got, well, two pieces of paper. Come on, let's get out of here quick.
What a great boost to me pension pot. Soon I'll be able to retire in luxury to that little village called Chew Magna with all those other people with large pension pots full of farts.
And I'm needed there.
Oh, crusty love for my dear husband. Slow down. You'll turn yourself into breadcrumbs.
Oh. Well, you know what they say, cheer batter, my love. A good baker will always arise again. It's the yeast he can do.
Oh, he does that all right.
Oh, yeah.
He does that every night without fail. And to prove it, we have a ten little bambini already.
Well, that's what you get for being married to a baker. Always a little bam in the oven.
Oh, they had cheer batter. I sent Tom down to that theatre an hour ago. He should be back here by now.
What if he's anything like his papa? He's probably ogling all those beautiful ladies.
Oh, it's not going to pay the bills, him loafing around down there.
Oh, now don't you get all stained up again. Everything will be all right. Something will turn up.
I don't understand. We've borrowed too much money already. Oh. And that old oven of ours is on the blink again. Oh. One minute it's too cold, then it's too hot. Before you know where we are, I think it might burn the whole place down.
What's that, Christine? Oh. Set the house on fire?
Oh,
have you any problems getting a bit overheated, eh?
Hey, Cliff, I reckon he's been fanning the flames again.
Yeah, a bit too fond of his Belgian buns, I reckon.
That's right.
Oh, is it you two again? Cliff Hindquarter with his fancy sausages. And Stan Turnwick. He dip his wick all over Cheapside. Oh, and Krusty Lover together. What a trio you make. Rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a tub. Who do you think you are?
The butcher.
The baker.
The candlestick maker.
Well, all of you go to fuck.
Perhaps we had better behave. Come on, Krusty, tell us your troubles.
Oh, well, yeah. It's probably the same with you two. Business is bad. Debts mounting up. Too many mares to feed. But I've got another problem as well. That older son of mine, Tom, he's gone and fallen in love. Ah, here he is now. In the clouds.
Oh, Tom, you're late again. Come here. What have you been doing?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, no. You've been doing more than that. You've been seeing that the rose again.
Oh, I was only chatting.
Chatting? Chatting up, I reckon. While your dad has been sweating his socks off to earn an honest crust.
Look, Tom, this rose, you've got to forget about her. These actresses, they're not for the likes of us.
Oh, your papa's right. These ladies are all destined for the nobles. She's way out of your league.
Well, I can dream, can't I?
Every night I hope and pray dream a lover will come my way. A girl to hold in my arms, feel the magic of her charms. Cause I want
yeah,
a girl
yeah,
to call
yeah,
my own
yeah.
I want a dream lover so I don't have to dream alone. Dream lover, where are you? With a love what's so true and a hand that I can hold to hold me close as I grow old. Cause I want
yeah,
a girl
yeah,
to call
yeah,
my own
yeah.
I want a dream lover so I don't have to dream alone. Someday, I don't know how, I hope she'll hear my plea. Someday, I don't know how, she'll bring her to me. Dream a lover, until then I'll go to sleep and dream again. That's the only thing I'll do to make my loving dreams come true. Cause I want
yeah,
a girl
yeah,
to call
yeah,
my own
yeah.
I want a dream lover so I don't have to dream
possible dream, is it?
This is the site.
The perfect location for my cheap coat store.
Oh, yes, your dukeship. Stack my sell up cheap.
Oh, you got me in that, your dukedom. Chico is a quality product that destroys all the competition around here.
Yeah. What are you talking about?
You're that baker fellow, aren't you? How would you like to make some real dough?
Yeah, are you taking the rise?
No, it's quite simple. I'm going to buy your shop and the two on either side of it.
Oh, great! Where do we sign?
Never! We've heard about you lot buying up half of London to build up your empire.
Yes, we lovers. We have been here for centuries. We are not for moving.
No! Never!
It'll be the best thing for you since sliced bread.
Oh, now you've come and done it, you've said sliced bread!
Remember your baker! Watch out, he's going to take a slice!
Get the sliced bread! Get the sliced bread! Save the world! Listen, I think you'd better go, your royal genius. He ain't going to say nothing now, and he ain't going to sell.
We'll see about that. When the Duke of Cheapside wants something, he gets something. I'll find a way. I'll get this site by fire or damnation. Fire is of course.
What?
Calm down, dear, and have a good think about it.
Yeah,
you're in financial trouble already. This could be the way out. Yeah, just imagine, you could sell up, you could buy that lovely little cottage in the country you've been thinking of, to Magna. And you need never sweat in front of the oven again.
Yep, no more worries about the oven overeating.
No! Never! You'll have to burn this place down to get me out.
But think of us! We need the money too!
Come on, Krusty. Think of the money.
Yeah, lovely money.
There are more important things in life. I do not want money.
He doesn't want money. That's queer.
The best things in life are free.
You can keep them for the best and be.
That's what they want.
That's what I want.
That's what they want.
That's what I want.
Yeah, Peeps is right. You two be prepared to give up everything our families have worked for hundreds of years. Over the centuries, they've worked through war, peace, and famine. And they're now suffering greedy bankers. I will not sell. Now I'm going back to work.
But Christy, all you ever do is work. One of these days, you're going to have an accident, you'll set the place on fire. You should sell up and retire.
Yeah, it's not fair on us. You should stop being such a misery and lighten up. We should all think about the good things in life.
Oh.
Look at the bright side of life.
Oh, that's a cue for a song then.
Yes.
Before you draw your terminal breath. Life's a great big pit.
on the right side of life. Always look on the right side of life. Always look on the right side of life.
That's right. Life is just the way you look at it. I've been keeping this diary for years now, recording all the events and emotions in this great city. I've recorded tragedies. I've recorded celebrations. But at the moment, there's a strange mood in the city, as if we're sleepwalking to disaster born of greed and recklessness, and nobody's doing anything about it. Most worrying. I think I'll just sit down in my chair and record it all.
Well, I seem to have a bit of a problem.
Oh, let us help you, Duke. Done.
Shall I go down to the apothecary and get you some ointment?
Not that sort of problem, you idiot. There, yeah, I need something doing, and you two might just be the way to do it.
Just say the word jump, and we'll jump.
I like the sound of that. I say jump, and you do it. Okay, jump. Go on, I said the word jump. Jump! Oh, what else should I get them to do? Oh, thank you. Bark. Good idea. Bark! Bark! Enough of this. I was talking about my problem. And I don't mean my wife either. Yeah, I'm going to build a huge Chico, the largest London has ever seen. The profits would be enormous. And you two bankers can share in that. The only problem is, best site is right where the baker's shop is. I need the baker's shop. I want you two to get it for me, even if you have to get rid of that baker.
Just say the word and that bread maker will be toast.
Yeah, and we'll spread butter all over him.
I don't care how you do it. Just get it and get it done quickly. Now to my other problem. Rose, that silly little actress at the Dreary Lane Theatre.
She can come around with butter too.
Nice thought, but she might just slip through my fingers. Now, if I know her sort, all she'll need to see is my wad.
Give me money. That's what I
want. Oh, shut up. Don't start that again. Work for me and you'll get some money. You just persuade that baker to sell his shop. Now, let's get down to the theatre. It's bunga-bunga time for the king.
I could have danced all night. Someday my prince will come.
Oh, I'm in such a party mood. Who wants to dance? Mr. P?
Yes, you silly old fool.
Oh, how about you, Dukey?
You've crushed me to death, you fat old tub of lard.
How dare you? What tosh? I'll have you know I've got the right proportions.
Perfect for a 10.
Oh, no.
Come on, Moll, I'll dance with you. Should we make it an orange tango?
In my life. Come on, Chiefie, your turn.
What?
Have a dance with Rose.
Oh, yes. Come here, you.
My name is Rose.
I know that. And I bet you're rather pleased to land me. I'm a big fish, a duke and all that. I've been looking for a consort. What do you say?
Oh, no, thank you.
Wrong answer, silly girl. Come on, don't be shy.
open up my little rosebud.
But I'm looking for Mr. Wright.
And I'm looking for Miss Wright. Miss Wright away.
Well, that's not me.
Oh, come on, baby. Come on, you and me. We can really set this town on fire.
We've got to be here.
Oh, I've got to go.
What's she thinking of? I'm a pretty good catch for any one of these ladies.
You know that it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I was to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. The time I hesitate is true. Trying to wallow in the mire. Try now, we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. You know that it could be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I was to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire.
What's wrong with her? Am I not hot enough for her?
Oh, it's not you. Well, not much.
Well, there must be something.
Well, the thing is, she's got this crush. She really fancies someone else. But it's no good. He's too poor.
Who is it?
It's Tom, the baker's son. He often delivers here at the theatre.
Baker's son? That baker's causing me trouble again. It's time to do something about it. It's time to get rid of the lot of them. Hold up, Langra! Come here! I know you bankers. You'd sell your granny for a bonus. Well, here's some real money, and I want some action now. I want you to get rid of that baker and get rid of his son.
You mean? Of course he means.
Yes, you're going to make it too hot for that baker and his family to stay in town. Do you understand? Now get on with it, tonight!
Oh, dear, I don't think I should have said anything. Rose, come here a minute.
Oh, no, it's just not fair.
Look, I know, the Duke is really cross.
What can I do? If Tom finds out I'm consort to a Duke, it will destroy him. I can't betray him. Now, you do understand, don't you? When I fall in love, well, you know.
When I fall in love, it will be forever. Many more.
in the mood for a little bit of loving, a little bit of whining, and a little bit of dining.
Oh, have some fun, everyone. Let's have some wine. Ooh. Yes.
Yeah!
London's gone. It's like wicked.
Yeah, bro, all the schools are burnt down.
They'll blame us. They'll always blame the kids.
Best if we keep out the way then.
Well, that was a great Barbie. I like me steak well done, but that was too much.
It ain't no laughing matter. What's going to happen now?
Well, I think I'll move down to that village, to Magna. I've got a notion to set up a butcher's shop with an apothecary's. Somewhere you can buy your meat and your pills in the same place.
It's all right for you. They like butchers in places like that. And if you peddle pills too, that's even better. But what about me? They won't accept me. I'm a candlestick maker. I make things.
Now, what I really meant was what's going to happen here now in the city. There'll be a investigation.
Ooh.
You know, CSI London, 1666.
Yeah, somebody's going to be in trouble. Whoever started that fire is going to be for the chop. And that's not a pork chop from me.
Best we keep out of the way then.
I think so.
Oh, look, Cheerbell, look. Our little bakery. It's all gone. Centuries of baking reduced to a pile of ashes.
Oh, our dreams have all gone up in smoke.
Well, they were just pipe dreams.
Oh, no, you'll never be able to have that whole meal experience. Another one where people say the same today as it's always been.
I was going to make my own special little loaf. I was going to call it Dovies. And give away a free roll with every loaf.
Oh, don't cry, Krusty. Oh, come to Mama. Oh, you don't think people might mention that the oven was a bit dodgy, do you?
What do you mean?
Well, don't you remember Cliff Hindcourt? He hear you say that the oven might set the house on fire.
Oh, best we keep out of the way, Cheerbell. Oh.
Do you think we should keep out of the way as well, Mr. Langrath?
Mark your eyes, as my old mother always used to say. It's better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to speak and remove all that.
Do you think we shouldn't mention that the Duke told us to get rid of the banker by button?
Shut up.
I've got a really bad feeling that that old cheapie will drop us in it if he has to. Out of the frying pan into the fire, all the London. Oh.
Best we keep well out of the way.
See, the fire didn't kill all the rats then. The King is very, very upset. His beautiful city of London, ruined. The whole financial sector wiped out in one night. Probably never happen again. Anyway, the King has asked me to conduct an investigation to find out how the fire started and where it started and who might be to blame. That's because I've got my diary with all the facts in it, ready for an instant replay.
Make way! Make way for the King!
I don't believe it. Everything's gone. London's just one big empty space. I know they call it the big smoke, but this is ridiculous.
London, my city, is ruined. Well, Cheapie, you got what you wanted. Now you can build the hugest cheap co store ever.
True, sire, but we must find out who caused this.
Well, Peeps, have you discovered who did this?
Not yet, Your Majesty, but we think it might have begun in Pudding Club Lane.
Right, bring out all the people. We'll get to the bottom of this. Somebody's head will roll.
And you two at the back, everybody.
Right, you are all to blame for the Great Fire of London.
But it was my fault!
I didn't say it was your fault. I said I was blaming you.
See, I told you.
Adults, they are so emotional.
Come here, you two.
What you need? I think so.
Johnson, Drury Lane, Ben Johnson, Galileo, Naseby, Prince Rupert, Oak Tree, Oliver Cromwell, Almost King, Puritans, Not the Thing, Open Theatres, Charles Hears, Scotland's Ours, Very Drear,
Shakespeare, Francis Bacon, Poll Tax, Money Taken, Sam Pepys, Royal Society, Tyburn, Notoriety, Dutch War, Civil War, Isaac Newton, Boyle's Law, Execution, First Jaws Dead, White Ball, Lost His Head.
We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. No, we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it.
Cavaliers did return, plague to bodies burn. Major generals, Marston Moore, General Monk, stuff the poor. Mighty Spain took us on, Armada came, Drake won. Pilgrim fathers went away. To New Plymouth, hope they stay.
Catherine, our queen, married Charlie, strange scene. Large dowry, no kids yet. When will he start to beget? Protestant, now are we. Bishop's back, it's not your pee. Clarendon, he's the boss. While Charlie plays, England's lost.
We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. No, we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it. We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. No, we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it.
It's no good, sire. They're all just stupid people.
Yes, God must love stupid people. I made so many of them.
It was that baker who done it. He had a dodgy oven.
Yeah, it was always over. He never got it fixed.
Yeah, he said he would burn the house down one day.
Is this true?
No, sire. No, it wasn't me.
No, he's an honest, kind, tender, gentle, generous, loving man. He wouldn't cause it.
Rubbish. Did you have a dodgy oven?
No! No! No!
Oh, yes.
There, sire. By his own admission, he's the one to blame.
Arrest him!
No! He's innocent! He didn't do it!
No doubt about it. Total negligence.
Right, take him to the tower and chop his head off.
Thank goodness for that.
What was that?
I said, oh my goodness, there's a rat. But sire, have you forgotten about Nell and the theatre?
You're right, Chiefy. Let's get back there now.
Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clemens. You owe me 5 farthings, say the bells of St. Martin's. When will you pay me, say the bells of Old Bailey. When I grow rich, say the bells of Shoreditch. Here comes a candle to light you to bed. Here comes a chopper to chop your head.
Oh, save him! Save him! He didn't do it!
Look, Cheapy, everything is hot and black and sticky.
It must be the tar from the roofs.
Nobody could survive this hell. My poor Nell.
Oh, and it would be awful to lose Rose as well. But don't worry, sire. We'll find them, I'm sure.
You just don't know what it means to be king. Without my Nell, I'll be all by myself. And I don't want to be all by myself anymore.
I know it's been a curse to be all on my own all my life. Maybe it's the kind of man I am. If only I could be nice. I really don't want to be all by myself anymore.
When I was young, I never needed anyone. But making love was just for fun. Those days are gone. When I'm at home, I think of all the friends I've known. despite all that I own, I'm still alone. All by myself, don't wanna be all by myself anymore. All sometimes I feel so insecure, the love so distant and obscure remains the cure. All by myself, don't wanna be all by myself anymore. All by myself, don't wanna live all by myself anymore.
There's no one here. They're all gone.
Nell, where are you?
Rose. Oh, it's no use. Oh, they must have perished, been swallowed up by the flames.
I won't believe that. My darling Nell can't be dead. Look, there's someone coming. It's Nell, I'm sure it is. Nell, thank goodness. Oh my God, what's happened to you? Nell, what's the fire done to you? You're ugly.
Oi, watch it. You might be the King of England, but you can't call Orange Mar ugly. I'll have you know I was once a queen. A beauty queen, Miss Balls Pond Road.
Yes, that's fantastic. I mean, it's fantastic that you're not Nell, but it's awful that you're not Nell as well. Have you seen her, Nell? Where can she be? I can't live without her.
Don't worry, Your Majesty. We're all safe. Well, I think she's safe.
The fire was awful. There was a terrible backdraft.
A backdraft is a technical term for an explosive event at a fire with a rapid reintroduction of oxygen into a confined environment.
I knew I shouldn't have had that spicy bean burger.
Oh, stop all this blather. Where is she? Where's my beautiful Nell?
We all escaped the theatre together, Your Majesty. As you can see, the fire swept through here. The Duke, he dragged you away. You're a bit tipsy-like, forgot to save us. But Tom, the baker's son, he did. He was so brave and so handsome. He was like a Greek god emerging through the flames.
That useless lump of dough.
Well, at least he rose to the occasion, unlike you, saving your own skin.
I was saving the King of England, which is a lot more important than a bunch of silly actresses. I saw you two nobles running away from the theatre as the ladies inside screaming for help and the flames were leaping everywhere.
Well, tell me what happened and where's Nell now?
Well, the fire was too strong for them to get out, sir, so I had to break that door down over there and I made them all hold hands, form a chain, and I led them to safety. And then I took Rose and Nell to my uncle's house for safety, like, you know. Well, look, here they are there.
Oh, Nell!
Yes, Rose, I'm glad you're safe. Come on, give me a kiss.
Oh, no!
That's enough of that. She's not interested in you. I'm not going to be a matchmaker for you anymore. Not that I made matches anyway, and I didn't start the fire.
We've heard her story now. She's in love with Tom and she doesn't want you, Dukey.
Yeah.
Oh, Tom, we owe our lives to you. You were so brave to enter a burning building like that. With no thought for your own safety.
This is wonderful. You saved my Nelly. Great job. So, you're Tom. What do you do?
Well, I'm the baker's son.
Yes. Well, all I can say is well done. I'm going to reward you handsomely for saving my Nelly.
and all the other actresses.
But sire, this is the baker's son. You know, the baker who started the fire. The one you sent to the tower to become shortbread. You can't reward him. He's probably as much to blame for starting the fire as his father.
What do you mean my father started the fire? What do you mean you've sent him to the tower? No, tell me it's not true. Tell me it's just a story.
Tell me it's not true. Say it's just a story. Something on the news. Tell me it's not true. Though it's here before me. Say it can't be worse. Say it's just a verse from an old song from years ago. From an old song that we all know. Say it's just some clowns to play us in the limelight. Bring the curtain down. Say it's just two clowns who couldn't get their lines right. Say it's just a show put on at the Globe that we can change over and start again. That we can change over, it's only a game. Tell me it's not true. Say I only dream. Say it's just pretend, say it's just the end of an old story from years ago. From an old story that we all know.
I'm sorry, it's true. It's all here in my diary. Bought sausages, went to see Mrs. Peggy. Oh, no, not that bit. Baker arrested, taken to the tower. Immediate execution.
Oh.
I'm sorry, Tom.
I don't believe it.
Maybe I was a little hasty. Oh, this is a right pickle.
Oh, Your Majesty, you must save Baker, for Tom's sake.
You can't ask the king to reverse a decision just like that.
You must show mercy. Mercy for the baker.
No! It's the real truth we need, not just mercy. I know my father is innocent.
You're right, Tom. Let's all go back to Pudding Club Lane and get to the bottom of this sorry mess.
Come on in.
Crusty loaf.
I don't want to lose weight this way. I'll go on a diet, promise.
It's no good. It's time for you to meet your baker.
But I didn't do it. Honest. I didn't do nothing.
It's too late. Your toast, mate.
Oranges and lemons. Oranges and lemons.
Here comes a candle to light you to bed. Here comes a chopper to chop off your head.
By tradition, you're allowed a few last words to the crowd. What do you want to say? Oh.
It is a far, far better thing I do now than I have ever done. It is a far, far better rest I go to than I have ever known. Oh. I can't remember the rest.
Could you give me the book?
And then I could read everyone the whole story, and then another book after that, please.
It's too late. This cold steel will have the last word.
Here comes a candle to light you to bed. Here comes a chopper to chop off your head.
Started here, but can you pin it down to a precise spot? Was it the baker's oven or not? I mean, haven't you got some CCTV footage or something?
I've got better than that, Your Majesty. I've got my diary and it's all here. Look, here's something interesting that I wrote the day of the fire. Duke of Cheapside meets hard up and land grab, and here's a quote. Duke of Cheapside says, "You have to make it too hot for that baker and his family to stay in town."
Well, I set my knickers on fire. That was an obvious instruction to burn the shop down.
It was the anchors!
Bounce, grab them!
Right, come on, you two. It's time for some truth.
Is this right? Did that Duke tell you to burn our shop down? Did you burn my dad's shop down?
I didn't tell him to burn it down. It was purely metaphorical. I just asked him to persuade me to sell his shop. I didn't tell him to set fire to it!
Well, he sounded like it to me!
That's why we stuffed those oily rags round the back!
Oh, we did!
Oh, yes we did, but somebody forgot the matches. So then we went round to the Candlestick Maker and they chased us away!
Is this right? Did you chase these two vagabonds away?
Well, I do remember now. We were having a drink and we were trying out my new candlestick.
Yeah, the one that kept falling over like you.
Well, so that could have started it.
Hang on. So we've got a dodgy oven and a dubious duke, two incompetent bankers, two silly fools drunk playing with matches. We have London, made of wood, and the hottest summer in living memory. Anything could have started the fire.
That's true.
Yes, nobody cared. You lot were working too hard. You lot were just having the time. And you lot, well, you were trying to make more money.
He's right. We all knew London was a tinderbox waiting to go up at any minute. We all allowed that to happen. Nobody should take the blame.
Oh, that's very good, but what about poor old Krusty?
Oh, crumbs.
Well, that's what he will be by now if he don't call a stop. Can't you call a stop?
Stop! Stop the execution! Bring the baker back here!
But will it be in time for my poor, disgusted bacon?
time.
You're out of time, my baker, my poor discarded baker. I said, baker, 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 you're out of time. Baker, 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 you're out of time. I said, baker, 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 you're out of time. Out of time.
I'm sorry, Your Majesty. I've lost the head. It flew off into the air in a graceful curve. Just like a Johnny Wilkinson conversion. But I've searched everywhere and I can't find it. I think somebody must have taken it as a souvenir.
You idiot, how could you lose the baker's head? Look at this poor widow, she's distraught. Bad enough that you didn't get the orders to stop in time, but what are we going to do now?
You're right, Your Majesty, I didn't get the order to stop. But when I said I'd lost the head, I meant the head of the axe! Oh!
Thank God! You mean the baker's alive?
You could thank God, all right, I had to let him go. I couldn't try again, not after divine intervention had spared him the first time, unlike your father.
Well, where is he now?
Oh, your father, he's dead, I made sure of
that. Oh, the baker, you idiot!
Oh, he's just coming, he had to go and change his trousers.
My legs is a bit wobbly. Oh, but
you're back from the dead!
Oh, I want to live forever!
Here, I think you've got some sorting out to do now. What are you going to do about poor old Krusty and cheer better?
Yes, dear. I know. I need a royal baker. You will be master of the rolls.
I'm going to be able to do it after all. Make my dough is loose. And I'm going to make hobnobs for the hobnobs.
Oh, yeah, you can't let that Duke get away. Nor none of his lackeys.
Yes, dear. I know, we need a royal theatre. And the Duke needs a new consort. Right, Stupid. I'm sorry, it's no more super shoppies for you. From now on, all you can build is theatres. And you can make one woman really happy.
Rose.
Your new consort will be...
Rose.
Orange Moth. Oh,
yes. Thank you. Come here, my lovely. Put your head on my bosom.
Oh, somebody save me.
I'll save you. I'll save you for later tonight.
And now, what about those two reprobates, Arduck and Landgrave?
Oh, yes. Come on. What would you do with two bankers?
Kill the bankers!
Bankers? Yes, what else? Yeah. I can't hear you.
Send your book to the Academy.
A fossil academy.
Come on.
Yes. Anything else?
Why? You're off borders.
That's a banker in the audience!
No, I'll be kind. From now on, you two can be palace gardeners and get your hands dirty every day. No pension, no bonus. Off you go. Clear off.
Off to the compost heap with you.
Go on.
Oh, now what about our hero? Tom!
Yes, Tom!
What are you going to do for him for saving me and all the other actresses?
Yes, Tom. Yeah. Yes, you're the kind of person this city really needs. To rise like a phoenix from the ashes. Someone who puts the lives of others before his own safety. Yes, I'm going to make you fire chief.
Oh! Oh!
To make sure this never happens again. Oh, and you can marry Rose too.
Oh, thank you, sire. Oh, Rose, will you do me the honour?
Oh, Tom, of course I will.
Oh. Oh.
So true love wins out. Our city may be in ruins, but we will adapt and we will rebuild a better city than before.
Oh, come on, cheer batter. I think it's about time you relit my fire.
Can we make it the baker's dozen?
Well, I don't need someone to relight my fire. Oh, Nell, you shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. My love for you drives a man insane.